throughout history, people have tried to understand the substance of life. It turned out that the cell is the smallest unit. It has this amazing internal structure, and some of these internal structures require physical and mechanical work. So I'm interested in nature's smallest nanomachines. My name is Ahmet Yildiz. I'm an associate professor of physics and biology at University of California, Berkeley. I am from Sakarya, Turkey. I was always captivated by life and its complexity. By the time I started the graduate school, I was interested in improving the resolution and precision in single molecule fluorescence. Most biological molecules are too small to be observed by conventional light microscopy. To be able to see them, we attach fluorescent molecules. These are also called dyes. We can actually localize a single molecule with a few nanometer precision if you increase the fluorescent emission of these dye molecules. We applied this technique, which we named Fiona, to molecular motors that walk along cytoskeletal filaments. So if we assume that cell is as a large metropolitan city, there are highways and streets that allow the delivery of cargoes from one place to another. And the trucks are called molecular motors that are similar to human body architecture. They have 2 feet, 2 legs, 1 body, and 2 arms. We are interested in proteins that regulate the activity of these molecular motors. Functional disorders in these motors lead to a wide variety of neurological diseases, such as motor neuron degeneration, schizophrenia, Alzheimer's disease, and so on. While understanding the overall transport system, we are also hoping to develop treatments for diseases that are related to their dysfunction. The general theme of my lab is single molecule imaging. From the physicist and engineer's point of view, we basically develop these very sensitive measurements. Then we need to find a complex problem that can now, with the development of these new methods, we can resolve them. And cells are the most complex structures that we can ever imagine. We're talking about a molecule that is made out of 20,000 atoms doing amazing functions inside cells. So what can be more complicated than that?